Welcome to the chapter. Here we're going to be creating projects using the idle thread. So in the last chapter, Eric, we spent time talking about some of the concepts. You said we're going to be dealing with mechanics on this
chapter. More than mechanics in this chapter. So in this chapter, when you're creating a thread type like idle or hardware interrupts or tasks in the future, we're going to have to create RTOS objects. So we've got to talk about how do we create these objects. You can modify or create them statically or dynamically. So we're going to compare and contrast those two solutions.
Okay.
Then we're going to talk about how do you create an RTOS project, what goes in to creating the project, what files are part of that project, how do you create that final project, build, load, and run it. And then we're going to talk about
We're also going to talk a little about ROV, right?
which is
visualization
the RTOS Object Viewer, which allows you to visualize when you have an RTOS project. You want to look at how many interrupts are running around in the system, what timers are turned on, all the statistics of the stacks and heaps and so forth, and that gives you visualization, ROV does, into those objects.
So you said we're going to create objects, and this lets us view those objects.
Correct.
You know, kind of at the data that actually gets installed in them and such.
Correct.
Okay,
and then in the lab, in a previous chapter, we did a driver, GPIO driver, to toggle an LED. We're going to take that actual code, put it inside an idle thread, and add a delay to it, and actually blink the LED inside an RTOS thread, that being idle to start with.
Okay, well, that's great. Well, let's go ahead and get to it.
All right.
Well, welcome to Chapter 6, Creating a ti-rtos Project Using Idle. Actually, there's really two titles to this chapter. First, we're going to learn how to create an empty ti-rtos project. And then, in the second part of the chapter, we're going to learn how to configure idle and add idle functions to the RTOS configuration. So as I stated, the goals really are, how do you create an empty ti-rtos driver project that we can use as a starter for the rest of the labs? Secondarily, how do we add an idle function to the actual idle thread? That'll be part two. Each one of these has a lab associated with it that you'll see on the next slide. The objectives really are, how do you take a ti-rex example? Where do we start? ti-resource-explorer. Yeah. Also, how do you add an idle thread into your configuration and a function? An idle function. We're also going to look at a couple tools, one being the ROV, the RTOS Object Viewer, which we're going to be using in the labs from here on out. And then there's a small part of this chapter where we talk about where can you find out more information about the ti-rtos modules, the BIOS modules, their footprint, and timing benchmarks. So in part A of this chapter, again, we're going to start with an empty project out of the TI Resource Explorer. We're then going to modify that project to create our actual empty project. That's going to be Lab A.
So you're saying empty isn't really empty?
Empty isn't really empty. We're actually going to start with quote-unquote empty. We're going to strip a bunch of stuff out and create a almost empty, an emptier empty project. So in part B, this may be, for some of you, the first time you've ever created a ti-rtos-based project. And so we're going to keep things very simple. As we talked about in chapter 5, we're going to replace the while loop with BIOS start. That's in main there. And then BIOS start is going to call the scheduler. Well, we don't have any other threads running around. We have no HWIs or SWEs or tasks or anything. So the only thing that's running is idle. So in idle, we're going to add a function that, guess what, Scott? Toggles the LED, delays 500 milliseconds, and then goes back into idle.
Over and over again?
Over and over again. Just like we've done before, but this is within the ti-rtos scheduler. So let's look at the outline very quickly here. So in part A of the chapter, a couple slides into this, I'll go over how do you create an actual empty ti-rtos project. Then we're going to pause, do a lab, and actually make it so. So you guys are going to go through the lab, create an empty project that we will then use in the second part. So in the second part of the chapter, we're going to talk about the RTOS configuration file, just kind of give an overview. Over the next, you know, 6-7 labs, we're going to use that configuration file, or at least view things in it. You're going to get really used to what that config file is all about, what it contains. Next part of the outline, we'll be using idle, literally. So we'll be talking about what is idle, how do you configure it, and how do you add idle functions to the idle thread. And then we'll talk a little bit about ROV. And then again, we'll be spending just a little bit of time talking about BIOS footprint and timing benchmarks, where to get them. We're not going to go through the actual benchmarks themselves. Then at the end, lab 6B, using idle to blink an LED.